And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. Last episode, we found a dead Cerberus operative and found out that they were involved, or Cerberus is involved in illicit operations, which should surprise nobody. We've been, faith our system, we've been to Amada. So Amada, okay, keeps track of what... Are these all the systems left in this... Wait. So I can't even see it. Unless I start heading over that way. I'd like to get a big picture of the cluster here. Let's refuel. What do I have? Batala, Karamvori, and Erin Larkin. Just a fuel depot. Okay, so fuel only gets used up between systems. Wait. Do I have anything to do? We're assembling our team of mercenaries, right? Experts, mercenaries, whatever you want to call them. And I think that's the main quest at this point. Master Thief. Kasumi. That's on the Citadel. I just want to completely plot this nebula first. Or cluster, what have you. Citadel. Emir, these are in the Emir system. Doesn't say what cluster. There's no Emir here though. Prison ship purgatory. I don't even know where the hell that is. Alright, so we're just gonna go to the other systems and then I might go to the Citadel after that, because I want to see what's going on at the Citadel, definitely. It's one of my favorite parts of the first game. No spoilers, please, guys, on any changes, or, you know, whether good or bad, and I'm just gonna check it out no matter what, and I'd rather see in the game, not find out from comments. Thank you, though. Okay, so I'm gonna go to this, where am I? I'm gonna go Karamvori. We have enough to get back, which is good. Now I remember in Starflight, which this game reminds me all the time about this old game Starflight I used to play. I might do an LP of it at some point, maybe next year, I don't even know. I have so much built up, I have so many games that I'm planning to play, you have no idea what's to come. But it reminds me a lot of that, and when you run out of space, I mean, don't say here, but when you ran out of fuel in Starflight, someone would have to come along and pick you up from the, I think they called it the Federation, I'm not even sure. And yeah, basically got charged 1,000 IU, I believe, is the interstellar units, intergalactic units, something like that. IU stood for it. Really awesome game from the 80s, believe it or not. One of my favorites. Let's see what we got in this system. Setor. A rocky planet with a crushing atmosphere, Setora has been scanned from orbit, but largely left unexplored due to its sweltering conditions. Its atmosphere contains nitrogen, but also an unusually high percentage of ethane, which can coalesce in pockets near the surface. The alumina-heavy crust of the planet can reach glowing hot temperatures during the daytime, reaching these ethane's auto-ignition temperature and creating pockets of flame across the landscape. Wow. For this reason, extravehicular activities are discouraged on Setora, and no company has been willing to invest in exploration. Gee! You think that would happen? Let's scan. Now, the other thing about this game... Oh, it's rich, nice. Starflight is you could scan planets, you could mine planets, but you ended up, you know, in a vehicle, which is remarkably like the Mako. Oh, nice, look at that. Iridium. We need more iridium, I believe. At least it looks that way. Look, that's even higher.
Probe launched.
Now what happens when they fill up? I guess that's the amount you can have on you at one point when your tanks are full. But yeah, you go around in a vehicle like a lot similar to the Mako. And you mine and stuff, and there are animals on the surface. You don't get out. I mean, actually you can go out, but very briefly. Once your ship or your suit runs out, you gotta make sure you can get back. No, that's right. I'm trying to remember this game. It's old, guys.
Probe launched.
So you got the ship. The ship lands on the surface, and then you've got the Mako. Like, it's like a Mako, but it's they don't call it that, of course. And all the iridiums, all the amps. So yeah, you basically have to make sure that you can get back to your ship, because if you make it past the halfway point, that's it. And then someone from the Federation has to come rescue you on the planet and charges you 1,000 IU, which is a lot of freaking money. We got two here. Actually worth it. You can now afford the Heavy Ship Armor Research Project. Cool. Go for one more. This is a really rich planet. Nothing over here, though. Hold up. I use two hands sometimes.
Launched.
You can now afford the Trauma Module Research Project. Okay, I gotta remember this, guys. Two research projects to do. Oh, wait. I quit out. I didn't mean to do that. Well, you know what? Let me run back and do these research projects then. I didn't even mean to leave, but... Crew quarters? Wait. No, tech labs are here. I'm already on the correct floor. Enhancement. Heavy ship armor. Hell yeah! The Asari-made Solaris armor upgrade is attached to the ship's superstructure. This will help the shield ship hold together if hit by a blast powerful enough to penetrate its shields. Do it. Hell yeah. Alright, what else can I do? I forget what the other thing was already. Trauma module, right? Unity heals your squad to full health. It's really helpful. A standard first aid interface can stabilize a badly wounded soldier, preventing death from all but the most serious wounds. The base technology, however, is ineffective on conscious soldiers who are currently taking fire, as each pain signal resets the process, really. A trauma module separates the metagel administration into two layers, active and passive. The active layer constantly distributes small amounts of metagel to fresh wound sites, and the passive layer handles major deployments to incapacitating wounds. When large amounts of metagel are deployed to incapacitated squad members, fighting members are also healed. I like it. I like it a lot. Hell yeah. So I can review here, I guess? Review your upgrades. Oh wait, we can go. Ah, here we go. So you're basically just looking at it. Alright. Heavy ship armor. Okay. So we really can't do anything, right? It's just look at it, which I've already done, so. What do you think about that, Morden?
Shepard, how can I help?
Any ideas on other ways to prepare for the collectors?
Sorry, have done what I can. Focusing on studying collector tech now.
Okay.
I'll let you work.
We'll be here if you need me.
Oh no, wait. I thought I got stuck in the frickin' pipe. Save. Wait, isn't there a quicker way? And I went out anyway. Calm room.
Commander, can I help you with something?
Normandy upgrades, anything else?
Any thoughts on how to prepare against the collectors?
We've got the best armor available. The rest is outside my expertise, Commander.
Okay. Thank you.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
Jacob. Alright, let's head back to the galaxy map then. Check out the rest of the system. I love this song. So I just want to see now. Yeah, we're all the way down because he used a lot of platinum and palladium. So I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Now I hit. Vatar. Located within the life zone of a dimming orange sun, Vatar would be habitable except for its carbon dioxide atmosphere and an icy surface that kills most oxygen-producing bacteria. Nonetheless, mercenary companies and slavers have numerous strongholds on the planet, out of reach of any galactic authority. Travel advisory. A statistically significant number of distress signals have originated within the 1 million kilometer mark of Vatar. Excuse me. Civilian travel is not advised. A significant number of distress signals. It's rich, though. I wonder if you can find one of these distress signal things.
Launching probe.
So almost full, I guess, of iridium. Well, not almost, but two-thirds, three-fifths. I find this fun. This is like the relaxing part of the game. It's more iridium!
Probe away.
Oh, nice, look at that. More here, right?
Launching probe.
Interesting, we can't rotate it this way, but only this way. A little spike there.
Launching probe.
I really want to fill it up and see what happens. Can I do that with 7 more probes? And this planet?
Launching probe.
Gonna have to go back and buy more probes. Definitely.
Launching probe.
This is part of my experiment here. One more will put us up. We can get palladium here now. Wow, that goes up really high.
Probe away.
But I want more iridium.
Launched.
I know it's kind of a waste of a probe, but I want to see what happens if I get higher than that. I don't think I can, though. I think I've mapped out all the iridium. Just really curious about it. Testing the limits here. Pretty much scan this thing to death, okay. I guess we don't need iridium for anything coming up. At least so far. Okay, so I went to Setor and we got one more planet. This one. Urwan Oche. Uwan Oche, or Uwan Prime, is a stony planet encased in ice under a methane-heavy sky. Named for the Uwan Consortium, the Batarian manufacturing firm that financed its exploration, Uwan Oche's crust provides much of the boron allotropes. What's an allotrope? Used in Omnigel throughout the Terminus systems, the area has naturally become a haven for pirates who attempt to steal the refined gel or its ingredients as soon as the cargo ships leave the atmosphere. These damn pirates, I tell you. Rich! Nice. I have 3 probes left. Right, so what happens if I go like this and we're full?
Probe launched.
Can we get more? I'm trying to find the upper limit of the iridium, if there is one. One more.
Probe launched.
We can keep getting more. Alright. Last one.
Launched.
Alright, I'm done. Alright. Still have to go to Batala. And, something else. There's one other. Ain Larkin. But right now, heading back to the mass relay. To refuel. Because that's a thing now. Let's call this Ain Larkin. Make sure I don't use half my fuel. Oh, we're good. One planet? Oh wow. That's a first. Even in the first game, you didn't see one planet. Utha. Oh crap, I didn't buy any probes. Punished with UV and gamma radiation from the class F star it orbits, Utha is no one's first choice for a planet to land on. Covered in seawater, Utha has a hydrosphere and ozone layer similar to Earth's, but that simply isn't enough to ward off the life-killing radiation. Its nitrogen-rich, oxygen-poor atmosphere goes unchanged by the few proteins that have managed to form in the ocean depths. Utha, however, has served as a way station for slaves escaping their Batarian masters. What little land it has is tectonically stable, and its considerable radiation belt and electrical storms grant cover from many common types of sensors. Fleeing ships typically hide on Utha long enough to discharge their drive cores and stock up on deuterium before trying to make it to the cluster's mass relay. And there's stuff. It's rich, of course it is. Very nice. Unfortunately, I forgot to buy probes. I know. I can't launch a probe. What happens if I try? Yep. Find a fuel depot. Hopefully, I find fuel depots in other clusters. But anyway, yeah, I'm not gonna go back here. I'll try to remember it in case I really need something else. But we need to go to buy more probes. And I'm not gonna come out here just to probe this right now. At least not yet. Because now I have to go back again. Fuel and probes. 30 out of 30. Okay, you can only have 30. Got it. Now, where's the one that I haven't gone to yet? It's like over this way, right? Yeah, Batala. Last one in the cluster. Only two planets here. Oh, three. Alright, let's go to the innermost planet. Logosiri. A step above a carbonaceous asteroid, Logosiri is a planet with a carbon-heavy crust and a trace atmosphere of CO2 and helium. Its surface is cool enough to have liquid water, but it is rapidly drying out, as it has lost the critical mass to have a self-sustaining hydrologic cycle. Nevertheless, the Batarians have colonized the world, forcing slaves to work in their mines and agri-habitats. The labor is hot, endless, and backbreaking, even in its low-G environment. Every horror story told by slaves everywhere in the cluster seems to be topped by one from Logosiri. The most famous is that of the slaver Silparin, who worked to death 420 slaves over the course of a galactic standard year. Hey, 420 though, and ground up their bodies for compost in his greenhouses. My god, he was eventually poisoned by his wife, but his shadow and his business model still hangs over the miserable planet. And stuff. Gravity half that of Earth. Just a trace of atmospheric pressure? No pressure. Moderate. Hey, this is really good plot.
Launching probe.
See, nothing I've seen from any Batarians. I mean, this would be the game that can change my mind, but anything I've ever seen from them is horrible. So yeah, no spoilers. I'm gonna get some revelation about them. That would be cool to see, though. Oh my god, what? Thunawanoro. A strange island of peace in the lawless Terminus systems. Thunawanoro is a planet of crushing gravity but abundant life. As its ponderous name indicates, it was colonized by the Elcor. As soon as you told me about crushing gravity, I thought about them. Who have several booming industries on the planet. Hydroelectric dams and biofuels from tough, woody algae provide much of the planet's energy. Mines export uranium, thorium, and gold taken to space with generous use of mass effect fields. Of course, pirates target the Elcor's shipping as soon as it leaves orbit, but the Elcor's deals with mercenary companies keep away all but the most foolhardy of attackers. Good to hear. I love the Elcor. Population 3,769,400. Colony founded in 2035 CE. The capital is Nahemathon. Surface gravity 6.7 G. You imagine our gravity 6 times more. Heavy. I guess even the youngest human would start to have back problems very quickly living on this place. Skin results are good. Do they? I mean, this place is. It's got millions of people on it. Don't they mine that we like mining for resources?
Probe away.
I'm gonna like stop getting iridium soon because just we have so much. Platinum though.
Probe launched.
I mean, who knows if I even gonna need as much as we have.
Launching probe.
Oh, ooh, we got a nice spike of palladium there.
Probe away.
More platinum.
Probe away.
I'm done. Got one more planet here. And then we'll be done with the cluster. Imagine that. Achievement update Explorer. Something. It went away so quick. Nirog. Nirog is a hydrogen methane gas giant whose moons are once home to Esul, a Batarian warlord who terrorized the Terminus systems. Attempting to unite a pirate army under his banner, he successfully conducted a rapid blitz against 11 habitable planets. Fortunately for the rest of the galaxy, Esul's crimes caught the attention of the Spectres, who deduced his hidden location and assassinated him. Esul's empire, built on a hyper-extended army, soon came crashing down. His long stockpiles of Element Zero had become something of a legend, and foolish spacers have spent countless amounts of time and money searching the Batala system, convinced they will be the ones that finally strike it rich. Great story. Moderate. I'm telling you, we have enough iridium.
Probe away.
Game, I know how to launch a probe now. Thank you.
Launching probe.
I love that sound. Okay, gonna leave. So I guess I got some kind of like achievement or award or medal or something like that for looking at a certain number of systems. It came up so quick, I couldn't see it. Of course I can pause the video back at the appropriate time. Find out what the hell it is. Pretty sure that's what it is though. So we explored all this crap. Nebula, 100%. So let's go get some fuel. Fill up on probes. And next episode. Yeah, I wonder what the difference is between the Omega 4 relay. That's Omega. So we have a mass relay and Omega 4 relay. Let me read this. The Omega 4 relay is surrounded by hazard beacons and automated warnings. Over the last 1,000 years, many ships have attempted to pass through it, but none have returned. The only ones to pass freely back and forth through the relay are the mysterious collectors. There are many theories why ships never return from Omega 4. Some say there is a black hole at the far end. Others, mostly the impoverished underclass of Omega, believe there is some form of earthly paradise. Most, however, simply think the collectors capture or destroy those passing through the relay. Holy crap. I gotta see. I don't know if we'll be keeping this guy, so I'll be disappointed. I gotta see what's through here. I've just saved the game.
Until we have a solution in place, we cannot utilize the Omega 4 relay.
A solution in place for what? Guys, please no spoilers about the Omega 4 relay. Recruit the convict at Hourglass Nebula. Help Saeed. Recruit the Krogan. Recruit the Master Thief. Citadel is here. Local cluster, this is Earth. Phoenix. Let's head towards the Citadel, I definitely want to be checking that out. What's our first jump? I don't know. It looked cool, but it didn't really have the impact, does it? Now, am I full on fuel still? I am, because I used the mass relay. Supposedly constructed by the long extinct Protheans, this colossal deep space station serves as the capital of the Citadel Council. Gravity is simulated through rotation and is a comfortable 1.02 standard G's on the wards and a light 0.3 standard G's on a Presidium ring. Gross weight 7.11 billion metric tons, that's all. Population 13.2 million, not including keepers. Now wait, didn't we find out that it was the Reapers who actually built the Citadel? Or did they just take it over from the Protheans and... No. I thought they made it. They enslaved the Keepers. But yet still saying that, Protheans. Well, maybe we know the truth. But who's ever made up these entries, it's not common knowledge yet. I'm just gonna dock and we'll check out Citadel next episode, guys. This reminds me of a Vorlon ship. Of course, it's a lot huger than that. That's us. Cool. I love these clamps that come down. Like some kind of magnetic. Yeah, chunk. Awesome. So we try to get another operative and explore a Citadel, whatever can be explored. Garrus. Morden. So saving his points. Morden's got 2. I'm gonna keep him with Incinerate, actually. Now we have this little ship. Oh, that's the fast travel ship. I remember that. This looks a little different. Is that Kara Ward?
Commander Shepard, enter the password and receive a free gift.
Oh my god. Kasumi put an advertisement?
Problems with collectors? Try Kasumi's credit services.
You're kidding me.
Please tell me your password, Commander Shepard.
Silence is golden.
Silence is golden.
Good to finally meet you, Commander Shepard. Kasumi Goto. I'm a fan.
Well, I'm getting dragged into this. Why the secrecy?
What's with the password and the sneaking around? Are you in trouble or something?
I'm the best thief in the business, not the most famous. Need to watch my step to keep it that way. I also needed to make sure all this was legit. And I have no doubts now. You're the real Commander Shepard.
Yeah, you sure?
What makes you so sure?
There's a certain aura about you. Like you've seen things no one else has. Hmm. Even without knowing what you looked like, I knew it was you.
Have you been briefed?
Has Cerberus filled you in on the mission?
Honestly, I'm shocked they didn't come to see me sooner. My fault for being hard to find, I guess.
You and Cerberus.
What brought you to Cerberus?
That's a bit of a story. Short version, they were looking for me, so I trailed them to find out why. Turns out they were looking for someone to join you on an important mission, and were offering a serious signing bonus. I had a thing I needed help with, so I made them a deal. And here we are.
What deal?
I assume this deal is something I should know about.
Yeah, I guess it slipped their minds. I'm looking for my old partner's gray box. A man named Donovan Hawk took it, and I'm planning to get it back.
Is she up there? What's a gray box?
I assume a gray box is some kind of hardware.
It's a neural implant. Illegal in most places. Stores memories, thoughts, secret codes, illicit information.
Hmm.
This one in particular belonged to my partner, Keiji Okuda. We worked together for a long time, before Hawk killed him.
Who's this Hawk guy?
What do you know about Donovan Hawk?
Mr. Hawk is a well-respected businessman. Arms dealer, murderer, generally not a great guy. His mansion's famous for being hard to crack, but I have a way in, and I think you're gonna love it.
You expecting trouble?
I doubt Hawk's the kind of guy who takes kindly to people sneaking into his house.
I always expect trouble. That's why you're here.
And this heist.
What's this heist you're planning?
Not here, Shepard. You'll get a briefing when the time comes. I need time to nail down the details anyway. I've taken the liberty of getting you some evening wear, though. You want to look presentable.
I'm like, anyone can hear and see this, right? Who's your partner?
Tell me about this former partner of yours.
His name was Keiji Okuda. The best hacker and entryman I've ever known. Unfortunately, he slipped up and made himself infamous. He stole something he shouldn't. He warned me it was bad. Something that could spark interstellar war if it got out. That information got him killed.
Oh, you're up there. I had a feeling that was her legs up there. What did it say?
What could he have found that's so bad?
He wouldn't say what it was, just that it was dangerous. He said if it got out, humanity would be in trouble. He encrypted it, wrapped it up in his own memories. To decode the information, you have to sift through all the time we spent together. Now those memories are all that's left of him.
I can see why you want it.
I can understand why you'd want to get it back.
Getting it back will be easier with your help, Shepard.
We'll take care of it.
If that's what Cerberus promised you, we'll get it done.
It'll be fun. And if we're lucky, you won't even have to draw your gun. We should probably wrap this up. You look pretty silly standing there talking to an advertisement.
Thanks.
See you on the ship, Shepard.
Travel to Bekenstein. Serpent Nebula. More glittering than diamonds, more expensive than surgery. That's how travel agents describe this. A mnemonic neural recall stimulator, also known as a gray box. It's an advanced device implanted in your brain. Your freaking brain, man!
Keepers. Fascinating creatures. Genetic constructs adapted to work in Citadel. Couldn't survive outside. Unknown purpose. Wish I could have studied them. Had other things to do instead.
Hanarsh. Okay, I don't want to stop playing. Galactic news.
I thought it might be nice to come back here and see how it's changed, but it's just like it was. Same dirty streets, same unrepentant scavengers, same revolving door prisons. Being security here is a terrible job. This is exactly why I left.
I'm sorry, sir, but I'll need you to remove any biotic amp you might be wearing.
What? Why?
Unfortunately, sir, biotics can be used as a weapon. The rules require me to confiscate all amps. Could you please hand over yours?
I don't have one. I'm not a biotic.
Oh. Well, when you objected, I thought...
You humans are all racist.
This reminds me of the guy from, what is that? The Upper Wars or something like that? He wanted a refund on his,
This recruits is a 20-kilo ferrous slug. Feel the weight! Every 5 seconds, the main gun of an Everest-class dreadnought accelerates 1 to 1.3% of light speed. It impacts with the force of a 38-kiloton bomb. That is 3 times the yield of the city buster dropped on Hiroshima back on Earth. That means Sir Isaac Newton is the deadliest son of a bitch in space. Now, Serviceman Burnside, what is Newton's first law?
Sir, an object in motion stays in motion, sir.
That's
no
right.
Credit for partial answers, maggot.
Oh my god.
Sir, unless acted on by an outside force, sir.
Damn straight! I dare to assume you ignorant jackasses know that space is empty. Once you fire this hunk of metal, it keeps going till it hits something.
Basically,
that can
yeah.
be a ship, or the planet behind that ship. It might go off into deep space and hit somebody else in 10,000 years. If you pull the trigger on this, you are ruining someone's day, somewhere and sometime. That is why you check your damn targets. That is why you wait for the computer to give you a damn firing solution. That is why, Serviceman Chung, we do not eyeball it. This is a weapon of mass destruction. You are not a cowboy shooting from the hip.
Sir, yes, sir.
You little maggot. You make me want to vomit. Okay, we're like 45 minutes in. Sorry, guys. I don't want to stop playing. Must investigate. But yeah, I got to call it an episode. I got to call it a night. Unfortunately, I got to get some rest. I don't want to stop playing. You can tell that, right? So thanks for watching, and yeah, see you next time. Citadel stuff. Exciting. Kasumi. Well, I don't think we'll see her until we get back to the ship, but still, we're going to come across some people and some interesting stuff. See you next time, Endure and Enduring. Grow strong.